A thriller tonight at McKeon Park will make for an exciting second episode of Tomahawk Talk. Michael Stern, flanked on my left by Troy Lynch and on my right by Kyle Kirchival. It was 5-4 Bourne. The Braves knocked off the Hyannis Harbor Hawks in 10 innings. Troy, Bourne got off to a hot start, scoring 4 runs in the first 3 innings.
Yeah, it was a very interesting game. More so top heavy, and then obviously it ended end heavy as well. I mean, it all started with the 2, 3, 4, and 5 hitters for the Bourne Braves. I mean, it all started with Willie Yan getting that hustle double to start things off, and then a few things went Bourne's way, but then after that, things just didn't go Hyannis's way. I mean, 5 errors in the game, it's a little bit rough, and you know, they capitalize it on first, but then Hyannis, they made a strong effort towards the middle and the end of the game. So it was very interesting, none to say the least, but it was those first 3 innings in that heart of the order that really got it done.
And Bourne had that 4-1 lead that we talked about, but then Hyannis came back. Carl Stagiaire hit by a pitch with the bases loaded in the bottom of the 6th to make it 4-2. First career RBI on the Cape, and then his first career home run on the Cape down the right field line. Tied the game at 4 in the 8th, but then the 10th inning was winning time for Bourne, Kyle, and it was a boy that had just been drafted, Toby Hanley, coming up with the big hit.
Yeah, coming through with the RBI single, and you know what? We've seen a lot of that from Bourne over the course of these past few games. It hasn't necessarily been the home runs, it hasn't been the extra base hits, it's been the singles in between the gaps. That's how you get the job done. That's what you do when you face some pitchers you've never seen before. You're just trying to put the ball in play, and you got to look at it from Bourne's perspective. You draw those 5 errors. Sure, those go against Hyannis for creating the issue or for having the issue, but it's Bourne who creates those issues, and when you put the ball in play, good things happen.
Bottom of the 10th was interesting, to say the least. Connor O'Neill came back out to save his own win, put runners on the corners with one out, struck out the dangerous Stagiaire, and then got Benito Santiago Jr. to ground back to him to end the game. But enough about O'Neill, because Kyle, you caught up with Toby Hanley after his walk-off hit.
Well, it's been a big few nights for Toby Hanley of the Bourne Braves. Tonight, coming away with the clutch hit in the 10th inning, and of course, that whole getting drafted thing is kind of a big deal too. How do you feel about that?
You know, it's, I'm just thankful, and I'm taking it one day at a time and just playing in the moment.
Well, he hasn't had his mind on Houston too much. As he just said, he's playing in the moment. Comes through with the heroic moment tonight. What, take me through that at bat.
You know, I hadn't seen him the whole game. He's a lefty. I've been seeing all righties. Just trying to stay on his pitches. It was a changeup. Try to take it the other way and just keeping it simple.
We've got a couple more games coming up. Make it 8 straight games due to the postponement last night. You guys ready for the stretch?
Yes, sir.
All right, well, hopefully we take this win into a few more. Toby Hanley joining me post-game. Thank you very much. We'll send it back to Tomahawk Talk.
Thanks, Kyle. It was 5-4 in 10, and you just talked with Toby Hanley, and now it's time to find out who you guys, and I'll ask myself who I think was the player of the game. We'll go in reverse order, because why not? I'm feeling rebellious. Kyle, who do you think was the player of the game tonight in the Braves' 5-4 win?
Well, obviously a lot of guys to pick from. Toby Hanley, that obvious answer, but I'm going to go with a little bit of a Troy Lynch move here. I'm not going to pick the obvious answer. Alex Moore, I thought, had a terrific start out there, and I think that's something that gets overshadowed in these extra inning games, is the start by the Bourne Braves starter. Went 5 solid innings, was able to get a couple strikeouts in there, and was able to get himself out of a couple jams, and that's the big thing for a starter, especially when you start off 8 consecutive games. You want to get things going on a high note. He's able to come in there, not surrender any runs on those big loaded base situations, was able to squeeze out of them, get the big outs when he needed to, and that's the mark of a good starting pitcher.
Troy?
Well, I'm going to go, obviously, in my own direction, and I'm going to pick not just one player. I'm going to pick the bottom half of the Bourne Braves lineup in that 10th inning when they actually eventually took the lead on that Toby Hanley single. It was Ironman who started off the inning with that base hit, Luis Alvarado, who reached on a fielder's choice, and then Henry, he eventually reached base, and then Toby Hanley finishing it off. Coming into this game, that 6, 7, 8, and 9 number in the lineup, they were 0-for-15 with an RBI error in a walk. That was about it. They walked a few more times, so they're seeing their pitches a little bit well. Harvey Shapiro mixed it up a little bit more, but ultimately I'm going to give it to those four batters.
And I'll go with Andrew Wance from UNC Greensboro. I thought he did a great job tonight, threw two innings, really racked up the strikeouts, had the rare four strikeout inning in his first inning of work, showed why he was a Southern Conference Pitcher of the Year at UNCG. That'll just about do it from here. Tomorrow we'll be back at Doran Park as the Braves take on the Kituat Cavaliers. For my partners Kyle Kirchhoff and Troy Lynch, I'm Michael Stern, and I'm also freezing cold, so this will bring an end to episode 2 of Tomahawk Talk.